Food allergies suck. And welcome to No Nuts November. Before we get started, I just wanted to say, all this month, November 2022, I am dedicating my videos towards raising awareness about nut allergies. Nut allergies can be really serious food allergies. They can cause anaphylaxis. They can be really, really scary. This is something that affects me personally because I'm allergic to multiple of them, so I've had to cut tree nuts just completely out of my diet. Thankfully for me, my allergy is pretty mild by comparison. I just get hives. I don't have my throat close up or anything like that. It's not something I'm going to be hospitalized for, but it is annoying enough, and honestly, tree nut allergies are scary enough that I just don't want to deal with it. As you may have guessed, I love food, I love cooking, and not being able to eat nuts has forced me to adapt a number of recipes so that I can actually have something that is close to the original. That's why I'm doing No Nuts November. I'm adapting recipes that traditionally or just originally include nuts to be a nut-free version that I can eat. It's going to range from something that I make frequently because it's a recipe that my wife and I love, to something that I am actually going to work out on the air, learning out loud for you as we go along. Please take some time to learn about tree nut allergies, why they're so scary, and how they can affect the lives of people in and around your communities. Today, we are doing pistachio ice cream. This is going to be part of my learning out loud series. I've never made this recipe. I don't have a recipe. I'm making this up as I go. My idea for a nut-free pistachio ice cream is to replace the pistachio, the flavors that it brings, with a variety of other ingredients. It's going to involve making a seed milk, turning that into an ice cream base, churning it in my Ninja Creami, and then mixing in some more seeds the next day. And let me just say, I haven't done any of this before. I've never made a seed milk. I've never made a non-dairy ice cream before. And I really haven't had to replace pistachios in a recipe before. So should be a fun experiment, gonna be a blast. Okay, in order to make a nut milk or a seed milk, you're going to need some specialized equipment. You're going to need, most importantly, a nut milk bag. A nut milk bag is an extremely fine mesh sieve. It, you can't even really feel the gaps there. Mine is a super bag. I got it from modernistpantry.com. I'll include a link down below. It's not an affiliate link, but it's where I got mine. It's the one that I can recommend. Also going to need a blender. You have to be able to process the seeds or nuts with water in order to create your seed or nut milk. The ratio that I've seen for all the different recipes are 1 cup of seeds to 1 quart of water. It's a 4-to-1 by volume ratio. Not my normal precision level, so I'm going to be weighing out my ingredients just to get an idea, and then we can go from there. For my pistachio replacements, I'm actually using 3 different seeds. First, to give it a real nutty, roasty flavor, I'm using 1/4 cup, which is 35 grams of toasted sesame seeds. That should give us the sort of nutty characteristic that we want in a nut flavored ice cream. Then I'm going to use some pepitas. This rounds out the 1 cup, so this is 3/4 cups, and that is 121 grams. Cool, great. My thought, my hope, is the pepitas will give us the green color naturally. That would be awesome. If not, oh well. But it should also be a better seed for making the milk. It'll provide the bulk of the, I guess, milk solids, or it'll provide the bulk of the flavor in the seed milk. That goes into the blender with 1 quart of water. For this to work, we really need to liquefy the nuts. I'm going to slowly work my way up through the different speeds on my blender until we get to liquefy. Thank you. Well, that was loud. Now transfer your seed milk into the nut milk bag and set that over a bowl or container of some sort. The downside to making nut milks, from what I understand, is it takes a long time to drain out. So I'm gonna hang this up, let it drip out, and we will come back at some point in the future.
2 hours later.
Okay, the seed milk has drained and I squeezed out the last little bit to get as much liquid as possible. It's not green the way that I hoped, but so now I've got some math. Ice cream should be about 10% fat. Unfortunately, pepitas don't really have much in the way of fat content. The sesame seeds had about 17 grams of fat before we blended and strained them. I have to imagine a fair bit of that got left behind here. So maybe call it 5 grams of fat. That's effectively margin of error, 1% either way, for, you know, a half liter of ice cream. So I guess I should be adding enough fat of some sort in order to get it up to the desired consistency. I'm gonna use some coconut oil. I also need to sweeten this up and get the sugar content in there. So I'll measure out a pint of this, sweeten that up with 120 grams of sugar. That's the same amount that I used for my strawberry ice cream and my lemon basil ricotta gelato. I like that level of sweetness. It's sweet, but not too sweet. Hopefully holds true here. Then we'll weigh that, add coconut oil to bring the fat content up, and we're going to use some gum acacia gel as an emulsifier, a binder, so things will hold in suspension and it won't break. All right, let's get to it. I want 10% fat. So the easiest way to achieve that is to actually set my target weight and measure out 10% of that. To that end, we are going to be doing 600 grams total. I'm going to need 60 grams of coconut oil and then 30 grams, 5% weight of our gum acacia gel as an emulsifier and binder. That's going to be absolutely necessary because I think without that, the coconut oil is just going to separate and it's not going to work. So that's the plan. So 30 grams of the gum acacia, 60 grams of our coconut oil, and then top it off to 600 grams using the seed milk that I made earlier. To 90 grams total. And now the sweetened seed milk until 600 grams. I'm stirring this up before I pour it in the blender because I want to get that gum acacia up off the bottom. I'm going to set this to blend, let it run for at least one cycle. I'll check the consistency, see how it's doing at the end of that. It looks like it's emulsified, so time to pour it into our creamy pint, freeze it, and we'll see you tomorrow. All right, time to stick it in the freezer. All right, so last night I checked on my ice cream and I noticed that it had separated when it frozen. So I pulled it out, I let it thaw out, not fully thawed out, but soft enough that I could pulse it with my immersion blender. Stuck it back in the freezer and it appears to have frozen correctly this time. Let's pop this in and see how it processes. There are a couple of reasons it might have separated. First and most likely is I did not use either enough or a strong enough emulsifier. Something to consider. The other possibility is it wasn't real cold when I initially whipped it together. Things tend to emulsify better when they're cold. And I'm gonna process this as a light ice cream. Okay, well, it appears to have processed. It's creamy, okay, that's good. I'm going to poke a hole in the middle here using the punch for my apple corer. And we have just some toasted sunflower seeds that I am going to use as a mix-in. Just toasted, not salted. All right, mix in. Let's see how it goes. It's definitely nutty. The sesame seed sort of nuttiness comes forward and then is paired with the coconut fat. The texture is not bad. It's a little loose. Like eating this, I feel like if I let it melt, it's going to separate. And that might be the truth. But, you know, I'll be honest, for a dairy-free, nut-free alternative to pistachio ice cream, this is pretty good. I'll have to read up more on dairy-free ice creams and how they get enough fat. Because honestly, I was shooting off the cuff here. It's one of the ways I like to learn. I like to try things, fail, and, you know, learn from my mistakes and move forward. I don't think this was a failure, but it also wasn't a great success. It's definitely passable. I'll have some people over later today to try a few of the ice creams that I've made. I'm sure they'll enjoy it, but I don't know that I would make it exactly this way again. It's a good place to jump in. Also, now that I think about it, pistachio ice cream is one of the flavors in Neapolitan ice cream. Don't know that there are actual chunks of nuts in pistachio ice cream. So the mix-in might have been extraneous, but I like that it does give a bit of texture and crunch. I'm gonna keep workshopping this. I think there's something here. It's a version one. It's not the best, but shows you can do it. Going forward, if I find out how to emulsify the fat into the liquid, it'll work out just fine. That's it for me today, and thank you for tuning into this month of videos about nut allergies and how to cope with them and how to adapt recipes and cooking techniques for something that affects a lot of people in the real world. I'm PK Sullivan. This is Breakfast for Pancakes. I'll see you next time.